First one, this is the last time out. He has played the entire game. He would have played the entire game in game six if it wasn't a blowout.
Our lives are filled with distractions. Email, Twitter, texting. We're constantly connected to technology, rarely alone with just our thoughts. Which is probably why there's a growing movement in America to train people to get around the stresses of daily life. It's a practice called mindfulness, and it basically means being aware of your thoughts, physical sensations, and surroundings.
There's so many different compelling studies that are showing that this is not New Age gobbledygook. This is potentially transformative of our health and well-being psychologically as well as physically. It can be useful for anxiety, depression, stress reduction.
There have been a number of studies that show mindfulness can lead to those benefits, as well as improvements in memory and attention. And at the University of Massachusetts, Judson Brewer, a psychiatrist and neuroscientist, uses mindfulness to treat addiction.
this is just the next generation of exercise. We've got the physical, you know, exercise components down, and now it's about working out how can we actually train our minds.
Dr. Brewer is trying to understand how mindfulness can alter the functioning of the brain.
We're going to have you start with thinking of something that was very anxiety-provoking for you.
Okay.
When I thought about something stressful, the cells in my brain's posterior cingulate immediately started firing, shown by the red lines that went off the chart on the computer screen. When I let go of those stressful thoughts and refocused on my breath, within seconds, the brain cells that had been firing quieted down, shown by the blue lines on the computer.
That's really fascinating to see like that.
Dr. Brewer believes everyone can train their brains to reach that blue mindfulness zone.
The heart is a blue, shoots up through the stony ground, there's no room. No space to rent in this town, you're out of luck. And the reason that you had to care, the traffic is stuck. And you're not moving anywhere, you thought you found a friend to take you out of this place, someone you can lend a hand in return.
One relaxation strategy that I used when I was feeling anxious or overwhelmed was deep breathing. Filling my stomach and chest with big, slow breaths and then feeling the air go out as I exhaled. This is also called a 10-second breath. Counting to 4 as I breathed in and counting to 6 as I breathed out so that the exhale was longer than the inhale. I learned that many high-level athletes use the same techniques so they can perform better and live better lives. So calming down our brains and our bodies with deep, mindful breathing can be very relaxing. There is no quick fix, and a certain technique may not work for you every time. But by building a base of helpful coping skills, you will be able to make progress towards a more balanced life.